Marble in the lane. And he's their takeover guy. It's a three-point game.
Gamble.
Daryl Kennedy on the right side has a shot. Instead, pulls it back out.
They've used great judgment, haven't they?
85-82 Oklahoma.
Man-to-man after the timeout. This should be on Seeger. A bad foul, too. Kevin Gamble trying to fight over the top. Ooh.
And look at Billy Tubbs. He is really upset.
Oklahoma, Dave Seeger.
He realizes how tough that one was against him.
1 minute, 44 seconds remain.
35.
Kevin Gamble is a 71% free throw shooter.
1-1.
He is 2-for-5 from the line tonight, and he cannot convert this one. Johnson with a rebound for Oklahoma.
Seeger took a deep breath. Man-to-man now, Iowa have been playing the zone. See if Oklahoma can use that judgment that they've had all this half.
Hawkeyes jump on him, trying to deny the passing lanes. The Sooners by three.
Now, McAllister has B.J. Armstrong. You might look for him to do something in a post-up area.
This is Kennedy.
Running some clock. Down to 10.
Inside to Grant. Grant banks it. It won't drop.
Great hustle.
Rebound Lojas of Iowa.
They've got a number now.
55 seconds remain. Oklahoma by three. Armstrong for three. We're tied.
Oklahoma was at a disadvantage. They didn't get back.
Score tied at 85.
35 seconds left. 85-85.
Hold it for one.
The shot clock is off. The crowd's on its feet. 20 seconds. This is McAllister. McAllister has 26 points in the ballgame. He's been hot the second half.
They're going for it without the timeout.
This is McAllister. 16 points the second half. Working on Gamble. Blocked away. Kennedy's shot won't drop. Rebound, Iowa. We're going overtime. Armstrong had one field goal until this.
Well, he knew he had it. You see, the defense has to stay back because DJ Johnson got back. And look at the emotion now. BJ saying, thank God, thank God. Ooh, what a big one to tie it up. And you need your big players to come up with big plays to block first and a little help here as Kennedy's shot falls. That could have won it.
I think every coach will tell you, when they get this far in the NCAAs, you need some luck. Mm.
5 minute overtime.
For Oklahoma, Kennedy has four personals. Grant has four personals. Grace has four personals. For Iowa, Horton has four personals. And Lorenzen has three. The Hawkeyes have the ball.
I still think Oklahoma needs some leadership. No tomorrow. Grace, your leader on the bench. They ran it down without him. They got five to go. New ball game. Love to see Tubbs put him in.
Armstrong. This is Moe.
Bounce
pass inside the right. The finger roll will drop. Rebound Moe.
Now why did Gary Wright flip that? He had the easy one. I just see Ricky Grace get up at the scorer's table.
Back to the quarterback, Armstrong. Lojas. Awesome. almost got trapped. 1 minute gone in the extra period. Roy Marble. Rebound right. There's a whistle, and it's going to be called against Johnson.
And the leader now, Ricky Grace, has to take over. This could free up McAllister a little bit more, get some punch into their offense. But that penetration by Roy Marble, they found the hole between the back man and the front man on the left side.
For Iowa, Kevin Gamble, number 35, returns.
Ricky Grace back in the ball game now. 6'2 junior from Dallas, Texas.
Three, Gary Wright shooting 1-1.
Gary Wright at the line shooting 1-1. Hawkeyes by one.
Curious to see what kind of pressure Iowa puts on if this free throw is made.
They're going for it. 87-85, Iowa. Inside to Kennedy, has it knocked away, but the Sooners will have the basketball.
The smallest guy, B.J. Armstrong down there.
We talked about fatigue being a factor, and yet Oklahoma's held up quite nicely.
I think they've beaten the timeline, and the defense, the zone, has enabled them to just relax a little bit.
Oklahoma wants the ball in McAllister's hands. McAllister has the shot.
Rojas doing a good job on Grant down in there.
Shot won't drop. Rebound, Hawkeyes.
What a screen off.
Right. Oh, pulled away by Grant.
He runs the floor so well. He had a great opening 10 or 12 minutes, then didn't see the ball much, then had some fouls.
Grant is a law enforcement major. He has become the enforcer here. This is Armstrong.
Where have you been, BJ? A walk. You can't catch it and fall to the floor.
There is timeout on the floor with a score, Iowa 90, Oklahoma 85 with 3:06 remaining.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand by.
I'm sure you never screamed about that as a coach.
Well, you'd want to thump on it.
Oklahoma has overcome fatigue factor and fouls to hang in this ball game, and look at the difference in substitutions.
Well, Tom Davis stayed in that flat 3-2, and of course you can get your second win as Oklahoma did, and they overcame that obstacle.
90-85. With 3:06 remaining. Pressure defense all the way now for the Sooners. Kevin Gamble working against Grant, picks up his dribble, but Gary Wright helps him. 19 on the shot clock.
Spread. You might look for a little individual basketball at the end of this.
Roy Marble has it knocked away by McAllister, and it's Oklahoma ball.
Oh. Marble upset at himself, but McAllister with a better play.
54, Lowhouse returns.
McAllister leads the Oklahoma team with 77 steals this year. He led the Big 8 in steals last year, and he doesn't foul very much. Quick hand showed there.
Well, they've been able to get shots on the baseline for Kennedy or for Grant. I would look for McAllister to hide down there.
Inside to Johnson against the big 7-footer. He's fouled. and the basket won't drop.
Gary Wright, Lohaus trying to help out. I think Gary Wright ended up with the call.
Ooh. Hawkeye foul charge to number three, Gary Wright, his fifth.
So Gary Wright leads with five personals.
DJ's a lumber. I'm not so sure he should have put this ball on the floor. Turn and go up strong. Here he gathered himself for the inside power move. Lohaus trying to help out, something Iowa does well.
Shooting two, David.
And Wharton comes back into the ball game, replacing Wright. Johnson now 3 of 7 from the line this evening. Hawkeyes.
Now the first half, Oklahoma played man-to-man full court extremely well.
Returning for Iowa, number 20, Jeff Moe. For Oklahoma,
the lead is cut to three. Jeff Moe comes back into the ballgame. Seager comes in, replacing Johnson rather, for quickness.
Looking for ball handling, Iowa.
Perfect trap in the middle. B.J. Armstrong calls timeout. And that's the second timeout for Iowa in the overtime period. They have just two remaining. We have 2 minutes and 12 seconds remaining from the Kingdom. Our score, 90-87, Iowa. Lost 6 of its last 9 games. 7 losses by a total of 16 points. It has been a hard luck ball club. Right now, they trail by 3 with 2 minutes and 12 seconds remaining. Tim Brand and Bill Raftery from the King Dome in Seattle.
Tim, they've got him in a perfect spot. It's the hardest point on the court to inbound a basketball. All they have to be careful of is the home run. But they're playing somebody on the ball, but they are backing off Armstrong and Ed Horton.
Kevin Gamble brings it in for Iowa. To Horton, and he's trapped. And throws it away. This is Grace.
Great job by Oklahoma.
What a look! Seager. Iowa by 1. 1:55 remaining in the game.
Grace finding people. Beautiful look. Now they're going to run some clock.
Wise decision by Grace, who looked for the three-pointer. Decided plenty of time left and went inside for the two.
Iowa's struggling once they've gotten some time off and trying to run their set.
1:30 remaining. Again, it's McAllister. He leads the Big 8 in steals.
So many clubs struggle when they try and take the air out of the basketball and end up with a good one.
We're down to 1:15 in the overtime period. The inside pass to Kennedy. Back to McAllister. Oklahoma has the ball. They also have the arrow for the next possession. Inside to Kennedy.
Well, they put Mo in for ball handling. And now defensively, they're struggling without Lohaus.
91-90, Oklahoma. 55 seconds remaining. Armstrong has it knocked out of bounds. It'll be Hawkeye ball.
But they are expending energy, trapping the basketball here. The guy they would most like to have it, Ed Horton. Big guy, assist to turnover ratio is inverted. The long gamble pass, Oklahoma on top of it.
Terrific. Iowa wants another timeout.
And of course, Grace now with Seager. Gorgeous look off the jumper. You can find people.
Why is McAllister's hands?
While Horton again trying to take some air, take some timeout. Timmy McAllister playing a sound game on both ends.
He now has 79 steals for the year. Quick hands.
Chris, you got to get yourself in position. It's not the hands as much as the legs, Tim.
But that gets back to the fatigue factor. They are playing now on intestinal fortitude.
Again, some wise coaching from the sideline, too, to set up the trap. They knew where the ball was being taken out of. They forced it into the worst ball handler on Iowa, Ed Horton. Of course, he made the mistake on both ends.
The Sooners have scored 6 straight points. They now lead by 1. 52 seconds remain. Oklahoma has 4 timeouts. Iowa has 1. And the possession, the arrow, belongs to the Sooners.
Chris, Tom Davis now. Once once you get it in, which is a struggle. He does run some inside screens. If it is a zone, they've been able to find the hole for Marble to penetrate on the left side between the foul line and the box. If it is a man, you'll see some inside screens.
Situation, throw at the length of the floor at the basket, and Al McGuire walked down the floor to look and see if the clock would interfere with the baseball pass from out of bounds. And don't forget, Oklahoma has practiced 3 days on the baseball pass. They've used it this ball game.
Save some energy, coach. We've got another one coming up which could be just as exciting. The Running Rebels of UNLV, the top seed, the number one team in the nation, going against Wyoming. Dennis Dembo, and he is loose. We talked to him yesterday and today, and he cannot wait to get to the Running Rebels.
Now, Lohouse, the big guy, we started the night talking about him limiting your visibility and your ability to pass the basketball. He's on the inbounder.
93-91 Iowa. 1 second left on the clock.
I would look for a deep pass towards the basket.
Thank you.
Ten, Brant. So the Big Ten has two teams in the Final Eight as the Hawkeyes win it in overtime. The MVP's McAllister for the Sooners. Who else but Kevin Gamble for the Hawkeyes? And once again, Iowa will meet the winner of the Wyoming-UNLV game, which is coming up next on CBS following local news. Now, for you folks on the West Coast, that'll be shown at 11:30. For all of us here at CBS Sports, Jim Nantz saying we'll see you back here in a half an hour.
United's cut fares from coast to coast. Fly for just $29 to $99 to more cities than any other airline, with as little as 2 days advance purchase.
You're not just flying, you're flying the friendly skies.
Saturday on CBS. During the darkest days of World War II.
Clark pulled our leg. Armin Gilliam is playing Eric Lechner.
Summers is fouled by Bassnight. That's his first.
Of course, over the years, only people in basketball tip their hat to the great ability defensively of Jerry Tarkanian's teams. Not given the recognition and due, he certainly deserves the soft touch.
The foul is on Bassnight. Keep in mind, Tarkanian runs a shuttle at center. Bassnight starts, then comes Richard Robinson, David Willard, even Elridge Hudson.
A little double up by Banks.
Lechner, not even close. Summers with the follow. Rebound to Running Rebels.
Wyoming with balance. Man to man.
Banks. This is Wade. Down deep to Gilliam. Rebound Summers.
You noticed everybody on Wyoming up on the outside shooters. It should help Gilliam down by the box.
This is not the pace that the Cowboys want. Demba. Whoa! With so much energy.
For Wyoming, in his 24th.
He's got some charm, too. I think great with people. Turk Boyd, shot of him.
Dembo shooting only.
Boyd replaces Sean Dent. Dent may be hurt a little bit. 78% free throw shooter. 3-2 Cowboys.
Dembo up on patio. Banks has two less three-point attempts than the whole Wyoming team.
Patio from three.
Got to put a body on him.
The follow by Gilliam. And the Rebels lead by one. We've got 18 minutes and 15 seconds remaining. First half. Tim Brant, Bill Raftery from the King Dome in Seattle. We have another whistle. And the foul is called.
Off the basketball. Both clubs teed it up man to man.
Foul charge to.
The chalk has prevailed in the NCAA. Three number ones in. Vegas trying to be number four.
In 11 years since John Wooden retired at UCLA, there has been only one national champion come from outside an Eastern time zone.
Here's the pace now. Rebound. Only opportunity break. Not known for his defense, of all the Vegas people, doing a good job.
Turn around by Lechner.
Good run by Gilliam.
Banks for three.
Oh, that's his game.
7-5, UNLV.
Goal by 13, Freddie Banks of Las Vegas.
We knew Dembo would have to handle against the pressure. He takes the guards. They can relax a little bit. He can handle. A lot of banging. Lechner now teeing up on Gilliam.
That's Lechner's first.
Foul charge to Wyoming's number 43, Eric Lechner.
I think he's just trying to establish his territorial rights.
Now he's the one guy they can ill afford to lose.
Lechner has battled foul trouble this year. He's fouled out four times.
Turk Boyd with a good hand in. Of course, Jim Brandenburg
known for the defense as well.
Ball came over here. I thought you'd have your first assist.
I was under the table.
Of course, a lot of people thought Wyoming would be home mending fences at this time of year.
That's that long rebound.
Boy, that bang.
Turk boy kicked that out to Fennis Dembo, but that long rebound is very important to Wyoming. They have to react to the missed three-pointer.
Dembo inside to Lechner.
Does he draw a crowd? He kicked it out, but he didn't do it well. Now, James Brown and Ubi Brown to the ball game, Wyoming and Louisville, and James Brown walked into that town behind the analyst. He couldn't hear the subway. He's a little nervous walking into Laramie. Came back with some great stories on Fennis Dembo and his ability.
For the block, and Patio is the man that was fouled.
Well, when you're looking for the three-pointer, you got to go up quick, and that's what Dembo did. And of course, knowing UNLV likes to take it, the penetration caused the foul.
Remaining first half, 7-5 UNLV. Sean Dent is on the Wyoming bench. He has his shoes off. He may be injured. Gilliam.
Gary Graham, who you'll see later on, was telling me when Gilliam walked in, he had brick hands. Now, I've never heard that said. Now he says he has the softest hands of any big man in the country. Great pressure.
Fox penetrates. The pass to Lechner off his hand will go the other way.
He's pretty good at having his hands ready. Some equipment problem over there.
That was Dent. He's lacing it back up.
Oh, Freddie. My goodness. Great look. On the money. Jarvis Bassnight reacting. Challenging the ball. Look at that. Is hard work. You got to move the legs. Strut. Turn. Little help here by Mark White. The reaction. They go after you on each pass, each dribble. Very difficult to get an easy one. But here's where Eric Lechner did not have the hands ready. And again, the rotation down helped out.
Bill, that foul was on Bassnight. That's his second personal. Turk Boyd goes to the line. He is the best all-around athlete on the Cowboy team. Shoots 67% from the free throw line, though. He's not a very good free throw shooter.
Tark didn't get his wish of playing UCLA. That was what all the players wanted. He'll settle for Wyoming now.
What a job Jim Brandenburg's done. Boyd converts them both. Wyoming now trails by two.
Vegas takes quick shots, but generally good ones, other than Freddie and Patio.
Last night, working against Summers, can't find it. Bangs it back out front. This is Patio for three.
Here's the opportunity break. Catch it first.
11 turnovers for the Cowboys.
Number 10, Sean Dent.
You mentioned Brandenburg and what he's done at Wyoming. A lot of it's been the defense. Summers tried the three-quarter. Made good judgment because it wasn't there. Sealed that baseline, caused the kick.
15 minutes, 5 seconds remain. First half, 9-7. Rebels. Gilliam, turn around.
But Armin Gilliam is going to get a lot of shots because you have to be concerned about the deep threats of Vegas.
Patio his first basket.
Good motion.
Pressure or turnover for the Cowboys. This is Wade. 3-on-1. Fast night. Good night.
And Mark Wade set it up by dribbling left and opening up the passing lane.
With 14-28, Jim Brandenburg wants to talk it over. UNLV leads 13-7.
Today's Chevrolet. best Chevrolet sedan ever built.
The heartbeat of America.
Corsica.
That's Dave Chevrolet.
Pete Rose just got tough.
Because now I use Tegrin medicated shampoo. Head and shoulders, not tough enough. Tegrin's four times tough on all four major causes of flaking and itching. Get four times tough with Tegrin.
No one really knows how your skin got sensitive. But if it is, try the shave cream with more advanced lubricants than any other. New Gillette Foamy for sensitive skin.
Introducing Axis Deo Cologne Spray for Men. Axis, the new scent made for a man to wear all over. Axis, the refreshment of a cologne, the confidence of feeling great. Musk, spice, woods, surf. Axis, the rest is up to you.
They're called Reggie and the Miracles. Georgetown faces a three-point assault of Providence. Then freshman power JRE leads North Carolina against Syracuse tomorrow on CBS Sports.
UNLV won three games in their conference tournament by an average of 27 points. The Rebels have won the first two games in the NCAA tournament by 25 and 19.
I know how they feel. A few years ago, I played the tarp. He ran away. Our kids were at the student pub early. But the defensive pressure outside opening up for Gilliam in tight. I think you'll see a lot more of that. And of course, Patio then able to weak side rebound.
Lechner has not been involved for the Cowboys. Wyoming has turned the ball over seven times. It's 13-7.
El Hud there, the pressure on Fennis Thembo. They just don't give you anything easy. Good help by Gilliam. Constant reinforcement by their partners, Vegas.
Sean Dent is back into the ballgame for Wyoming. This is Lechner on Gilliam.
That's his shot, but he forced him a little deeper.
Wade, the quick outlet pass.
Nice play. Gilliam. Hudson with a gorgeous pass.
15-7. Personal foul on Eric Lechner.
Here's the post pass and good position. Gilliam giving it up and a little theatrics. They're big guys. Play on. Officials in the game from different conferences. Jody Sylvester, Big East, Big Ten, made that particular call. He's been used to sabanging.
Nice pass inside. This is Dent. Boyd.
And a good non-call because he didn't have control of the basketball.
24, Boyd.
Wyoming pulls within six. 12:52 remaining first half.
Boyd curled up.
Bassnight walk gets away with it and scores.
A hook and a walk. And Bassnight looking for some airtime.
17-9. Rebels 12:32. First half. This is Dent to Boyd.
Oh,
nice backdoor.
Sure was. Old time. Years ago, the only place they did that, CCNY, with that Alvin. Ooh, Banks and Dent.
End of the game for the Rebels, number
these two
14.
Teams have been having words since they lined up for the tap.
32,
Gary. Sean Dent said, Fennis action. If he plays as well as he talks, we'll be fine.
Is by number 10,
Gary
Sean
Graham
Dent
comes into the game. Banks goes out.
Team foul number five.
Gary Graham with the ball. Brother Ernest played at the University of Maryland. He could light him up from outside.
I can see the opening for Gilliam in there.
Gilliam.
Even when Wade has the basketball.
Gilliam now has 10 points. UNLV 19. 18, Wyoming 11.
Mark Wade just said, I didn't hit anything.
Rebel foul.
But he reacted so well.
Mark Wade, his first.
Dent and Wade are still jawing right in front of us.
A lot of woofing on the floor.
They've done a good job on Dembo. Dembo's taking it as a personal challenge.
Bad shot. And there's number three.
Three on Lechner.
Changes the whole game. They've got Fennis Dembo out of the game, on the floor, and right now Lechner's lap will be out by Brandenburg, and the swipe. Position, you got to respect the checkout and get back.
Dave Lodgins comes in. Lechner will sit down and he leaves with three personal fouls and just 2 points. Wyoming trails by eight.
They're going right to Gilliam with Lodgins on him, taking advantage of the inexperience.
Graham for three.
3 points for Graham.
You can't turn the ball over against UNLV.
You better run your half court set. Great help. Charge. Whoops, they got to step in. They can't get anything going their way.
Throwing the ball all over the place. It's just like chumming for Sharks. UNLV will come to it and attack it relentlessly.
Foul on Wyoming is number 24.
They are amazing.
9-7
with 11 minutes left in the first half, and he may not use his towel tonight.
For Wyoming, returning is 25, Reggie Fox.
Concerned look on Brandenburg because they're unable to get their half-court set, run their motion, and get good shots.
Number 33,
Fox comes back into the ballgame. Boyd will sit down for Wyoming. Hudson is at the line. We are shooting 1-1 already in the bonus. Rebound Dembo. 22-11. UNLV.
Good hustle by Lodges.
And again a whistle. And Lodging comes in and really starts to play aggressively off the bench. Lodging, 6'10", 230-pound junior from North Vancouver, British Columbia. Played on the Canadian national team a year ago.
First time Dembo's gotten the ball where he can be a threat.
Dembo tried to dunk it, and Willard fouled him.
Good defense. You don't give up the easy one. Terrific reaction. The bench applauding Willard. They very alert.
Second on Willard.
If he had just laid it in, it wouldn't have been blocked. Took it behind his head for the slam.
Amazing. Well, he's a little bit frustrated. Hasn't been able to get on the board easily. But a struggle.
The shooter has 34.
He has 3 points, one for one from the line. He's a 78% free throw shooter, shooting two. Two to 12, UNLV, trying to pull it in 10. He made all 16 of his free throws against UCLA.
Chris, composure. Iowa started poorly. As you recall, rattled Wyoming the same boat. But this relentless pressure really questions your judgment a little bit. Stack set. Boy, they're just going to the big guy.
Gilliam down low. Nice turnaround.
Now, here's a guy. Well, this should be a take, right? Leaning over the baseline. Elhud. And Dembo always has something to say. He could really aggravate you, don't you think, if you were on the floor?
Now, what did you teach your guys if the defender was leaning over the inbound line?
Well, I would say throw it off their lower body, but I would hit to make sure it was low enough that they didn't become Sopranos.
Eldridge Hudson.
But it's one of those things, you got to get them away from the baseline.
It's a good thing this is late night TV. 24-13, UNLV. Here it is.
The fight now, of course, defense trying to get set up and...
See what he did? He swatted the ball away from Dembo while he was standing out of bounds.
Can't do it. You know, Gilliam didn't play in high school. He was a wrestler in Pittsburgh. Played a little bit, I should say, but wasn't a great player.
and Sonny Vaccaro runs the Dapper Dan game, didn't put him on the Pennsylvania All-Stars. And Timmy Gergovich, the assistant, he had heard he had some abilities, put him in, or got him, or helped him get into junior college, and of course he ends up being probably a first-round draft pick after this year.
Dembo misses two after hitting 19 straight in this tournament. 24-13, UNLV, 10:38 remaining, first half.
As the ball wasn't inbounded, thus the two shots.
This is Reggie Fox.
Vegas makes it tough to turn the corner out front. You can't swing it side to side.
Dembo for three. Yes.
Well, he got down and ran the box, and now he's pointing at the bench. He's got a lot of hot dog.
Gary Graham for three. Followed by Gilliam, and a foul on Lechner. Correction, Lodgers.
Well, Venice Dembo was so busy pointing at the Vegas bench. Down underneath, you'll see the miss. He had pointed, of course, the missed time hit the rim, Lodgins a little bit late. But I think Fenix should play a little bit. You know, it's all right when you got 40 to start pointing at people.
Lodgins sits down, Lechner comes back in. He has three personal fouls. Gilliam has a weightlifter's body and a baby's soft hands.
Speaking of soft hands, huh?
Lead is 12, 9:58, first half.
Vegas has backed off the pressure. Now at the half court, a little trap, run a jump. See Gary Graham in the middle, looking to be the free safety. Now this is work.
Fox. Dembo.
The only thing Vegas didn't do was rebound. Set there. Willard looking for Gilliam.
Willard from 15 feet.
Willard. I saw him early in the year, preseason NIT. He's a pretty good offensive player. What pressure on the basketball.
Lechner gets it back. The foul's going to be on Gary Graham for reaching in.
I can't blame Brandenburg for playing Lechner. He feels, hey, look, don't foul, play as long as you can. We got to get back in this game now.
You're seeing the shuttle system run by Jerry Tarkanian.
24 point returns for Wyoming.
He is. They just work him in and out of that center position as Bastnight comes back in, replacing Willard. Boyd comes back in for the Cowboys.
It's a correction.
Starting early, huh? You'd admonish your child for biting the towel, wouldn't you? You let grown-ups get away with it.
UNLV has been in complete control.
Graham did a good job presenting himself as a passing lane.
Again to Gilliam, the turnaround. Lechner with the rebound, the whistle and a foul, and it's on Gary Graham. And every time that whistle blows, Lechner takes a deep breath.
He took a peek at the official. That's what I was chuckling about.
Rebel foul, charged to 32. Gary Graham is second.
He's an awfully nice young kid. Lechner is very soft-spoken, shy guy. Personality almost opposite of Fenice Dembo's. Fenice is very outspoken. Very energetic.
Fenice is the guy you don't want to have breakfast with.
Wyoming now has missed five free throws in a row. They trail 30-18.
Both clubs man-to-man. Vegas will run and jump on occasion.
Banks.
A little too close for Freddie, huh?
3-on-1.
Poise they need. Would have been a gamble to make that pass. How often half if you see that. Vegas asleep defensively.
30-20. 8 minutes. First half. Mark Wade, the quarterback for the running Rebels.
It's going to be on Gillian. Oh. They're going to use opportunity breaks whenever they can here. Not having control, sneaks a peek at his teammate, but just can't get it back. Graham filling in, hustling.
He actually had dent on the right side.
Well, he didn't have control. He fumbled it, and then the defender got in. And, of course, the secondary break there with Lechner.
The foul was on Gilliam. That's his second personal foul.
Unbelievable gamble, huh?
Lechner. The Cowboys.
Well, they almost have to, though, Bill. If they don't, they're taking a gamble of getting blown out.
Great respect Brandenburg must have for Lechner's self-control.
Willie Jones, consummate role player, usually the first forward off the bench. And with 7 minutes and 51 seconds remaining in the first half of the Kingdome, it's UNLV 30, Wyoming 22. East Providence and Georgetown, then moving to the East Regional. The Orangemen of Syracuse against the Tar Heels of North Carolina. You know, Bill Raftery, as fast as the game has gone and as quick as the pace has been, Wyoming's hanging tough, trailing by 8 with 7:51 first half.
Of course, the concern, I'm sure, Jim Brandenburg is Eric Lechner. He's got to stay on the floor, and Dembo has to get into a comfort zone.
Lechner has three personal fouls.
Well, they're going right at him. Tark, say, let's get number four, Eric Lechner.
Outstanding hands by Turk Boyd makes the steal for the Cowboys.
Of course, the post pass, you got to work at it.
Boyd throws it away. Now look at this. We talked about tempo prior to the game. Wyoming wants to hold it up and slow things down. And yet, in 22 possessions, 21 of them, they shot the ball in 21 seconds or less.
And no surprise on Vegas, is there? Great defense again, the help. That was a kick. Good call. Sam Lechner. Of course, he works, I believe, Big Ten and ACC right on top of it. But Wade has the ability to read ahead. Almost came up with it.
That's the story.
That has hurt them.
And yet 10 turnovers, and they still only trail by 8.
A confident team.
Hanging in. Playing tough. Now, this is a team that has been underrated, certainly unnoticed across the country.
Of course, they don't get the media attention.
Lechner in the lane, and he's fouled by Willard.
Now, Willard made a mistake there. He really didn't have to. Lechner was off balance, fading away. He leaned in and gives him a chance at two freebies.
Willard. Gasnight, Willard, Robinson, Hudson, they've all been playing in that middle for UNLV. That's 20 fouls to give.
Two free throws for 23.
Contrast in styles, not only between these two teams, but Wyoming and Nevada, maybe neighboring states, but you think of Las Vegas, you think of the glitter, the fast pace, you think of Wyoming, you think of the laid-back, wide-open spaces. Newspaper columnist this week said there are two seasons in Wyoming. Rodeo week and winter.
Now they got their basketball. First, their energy-related state. They've had their problems. And they've all rallied around this club.
You're right about the basketball.
There's that high-low again. Willard with steps.
He walked.
He had Gilliam, but he looked for the shot first. And Tark up and after Sam Lechner. He's a gentle guy, you know that? Sat next to him this morning at breakfast with his family.
Both these coaches are.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in Brandenburg's 9 years, he's won 3 WAC titles, 2 trips to the NCAA, a trip to the NIT.
Oh, he scored.
Lechner scores and fouls.
Oh, I thought he gave it the old Willis Reed hop.
And Wyoming. now within five and a chance to cut it to four.
You see how important Lechner is. It's tough to front. He's strong. Gets that little break in his back to ward the man off. The advantage step, and that's four on Willard, isn't it?
I'm not so sure. That's not the reason they had him in there.
Now they're going to give 20, I guess. Jimmy Gergovich alongside Willard explaining a thing or two.
The lead is just four.
Knocking at the door.
The Wyoming fans have come to their feet.
Look at the aggressive trapping of the post.
Lechner. No foul call.
Bassnight strong to the goal. Gambling with Lechner has certainly paid off, hasn't it?
Jones. Oh, misses the dunk. Lechner. There's a foul. It's going to be against Bassnight. And that's three on Jarvis Bassnight.
Willie Jones, Oakland Junior College. Tremendous bounce to the goal. And this is how to finish it off. Aggressive. Ooh. Read those lips.
Jones was an honorable mention All-American at Oakland Junior College. He shoots only 66% from the line.
They could have really helped himself with these charity tosses. Wyoming's done a good job taking away the deep shot. They really haven't got inside enough for me.
It's down to three. Graham. Rebound Cowboys. And a foul's going to be on Mark Wade. Rebels led 30-18. The Cowboys have run off nine straight, and they've stopped going to Gilliam inside.
Oh, this is get even. Beat them at their own game. Four people out on the break. Chris Wade ends up giving the foul, but right now, opportunities presenting themselves, and I just think Tark's got to scratch it a little bit. You got Gilliam in there. He hasn't touched the ball enough. They've been pounding to Bassnight and Willard. Gilliam is the guy that can ring the bell for Vegas.
The running Rebels have not scored from the free throw line. And look at Wyoming. If they had converted the free throws, they'd be ahead now. They're down to two. Boyd cuts it to one. It's 30-29. UNLV with 5:30 remaining in the first half.
Willie Jones doing a great job on Armie Gilliam. Great pressure. Causes now Wade. Really should have played. He knew it was backcourt. He should have touched it in here. Now you've got it into an offensive threat position. Clark saying it was touched. Good coordination by the officials.
Wyoming has scored 11 straight points. They now have the ball and can take the lead for the first time tonight.
Got John Moreau, game summary there. John Moreau discussed it with Jody Sylvester. Good coordination by the officials. Fade away. They're going to give this to Willie Jones, but Jarvis Bassnight could have had it as well. They're running in the middle of the floor, trying to fight to get back. Good job by Jones. A little smile.
Wyoming's number 32, Willie Jones, first personal. 21-44.
Shooter is 44. Gary Graham sits down for for UNLV. So now it's Patio, Gilliam, Bassnight, Banks, and Wade. This is Bassnight. And the Rebels are now 0 for 3 from the line.
The long rebound, that's two now. Gilliam may have gone up and down.
Rebound Lechner. Three on one. It's 31-30 Cowboys.
Finishing the breaks. Key element. Simple for Vegas, isn't it? Wouldn't you pound it into him?
Absolutely.
Let the big guy have a field night. Over penetration by Sean Dan.
Banks.
They had Lechner deep. Good move by Dembo.
UNLV has been ice cold from long range.
I'll assure you one thing, they'll keep taking him.
What did you say about Banks? He has no conscience.
He gets his feet set.
Dembo.
Very early.
The Rebels are running. This is Patio. 3 points.
3 points for Patio.
Great confidence. They know they can guard, so they're willing to take the quick long shot.
Just as quickly, UNLV is back up by four.
Dembo's got to get into the flow. Still forcing. He's got his man. That's better. Pound it in there, too.
Dembo now has 12 points.
Nobody back.
Dent.
Tarkanian is shot.
Score tied at 35.
We're tied at 35. Gilliam pulls the string. Rebound Dembo.
Did you see Lechner back off? Very intelligent.
Richard Robinson comes in, so they continue the shuttle inside in the middle. Dennis Dembo sits down to take a break.
And Jim Brandenburg wisely getting Lechner out as well to make sure he doesn't get number four.
Gilliam, jump hook.
Gilliam.
Nothing but net.
Just a little bump freedom.
Arbon Gilliam now with 18 points. UNLV with a two-point lead. Too much dribbling again by Denton. Turns it over.
The guards have over-penetrated and caused problems, and twice, right in front of Coach Tarkanian, they kicked it off their legs. So they can play off Wade.
Gilliam is mugged. And it's going to be on Summers.
I think Dent, they may give it to, he helped out, but this is what I love. That takes a lot of work. The leg movement, the reaction, it's just terrific. Keep going after it. He uses zigzag drill to set that up.
Dembo and Lechner will now come back into the ballgame for Wyoming.
43, Eric Lechner.
So much for that strategy. Lechner going to be an offensive factor. They're just worried about him on the defensive end.
UNLV is 0 for 3 from the free throw line tonight. Hard to believe Gilliam did not take up basketball until his junior year in high school. The Rebels. 1 minute, 30. 49 seconds remaining in the first half. We're at the King Dome.
Graham with great pressure and a lot of mouth, too.
Lechner. Nice look.
Plays within the confines of the offense here. You see the three-quarter. He waves Lechner baseline. Of course, the great finish here by the big guy. He's played so well with the foul problems. But Dembo just stepped in. Patio ran right over him.
It's 1-1 for 34. Dennis Dembo.
38-37. UNLV. Gets away from it. Lechner gets the rebound for Wyoming. Seconds in the half. 29 seconds on the shot clock.
Dembo used Lechner so well to get free.
This is Dembo. Oh. The slide. Venice, the Venice in Wyoming leads by one. Dembo has 14 points. The Cowboys lead by one, and the Rebels will hold it for one shot.
They got to be concerned. Penetration in the three.
Wyoming ball with 1 second on the clock.
Some strength to get it that far.
That's the end of the first half with a score. Wyoming 39, UNLV 38. CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA basketball championship continues after this message and a word from your local stations.
CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Domino's Pizza. Avoid the...
Started running the basketball, opportunity breaks. Opportunities presented themselves. They looked down. They outnumbered Vegas, and I'm sure Tarkanian is furious at this. Willie Jones, no balance on the floor to Sean Dent. Easy. Chippy.
Turk Boyd came off the bench. He scored 10 points. They went outside. They went inside.
And the power game, you saw Dembo, the point forward there, describing to Lechner where he should go. And the big finish by Eric.
All right, now look at the three-point shooting here. UNLV has hit only three of its 14 three-point shot attempts.
Would you like to be an outside shooter?
That's right, but even with those numbers, Jerry Tarkanian likes the rule, and when you talked to him earlier, he said he wants to keep shooting him.
I'll tell you, I don't think it's a long shot, Billy. I really don't. I'd much rather have my kid shoot from 19-9 or 20 feet or 21, whatever it is, an uncontested shot from there than shoot a 10-foot shot with a hand in his face.
Wyoming by one. We're at halftime, and CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship. 23,035 fans have come to the King Dome. And look at this, Bill Raftery.
One of the keys, according to Coach Brandenburg, is to force Vegas into poor shooting. Done an outstanding job there. The three left with tremendous defensive ability, force you into tough shots. Right here you can see, close to the season norm, holding Vegas to 43.
Right now, 38 points for UNLV seems to be pretty much in the range that Jim Brandenburg wanted to keep this game.
Man-to-man, both clubs. A little down double.
Banks
trying to get him in the game. He's 1-for-8 before that one.
Brady Banks, assisted by Wade.
Come on! always does a better job.
Summers working on Bass Knight.
Look at this. Fell asleep again. I have not seen this very often by a Vegas team. A lot of breakdowns in their half-court man.
Wyoming by one.
Curious to see if they go to Gilliam. Not showing any respect for Mark Wade, are they?
Well, bodies flying underneath. Play continues. This is Graham in the lane, and he lays it in.
That's what outside shooting does for you. Defense reacts quickly, balances off. You can blow by with the bounce.
Turk Boyd picks up his dribble. Down to Lechner in the lane. The turnaround jumper, no good.
Shot that just so alert.
Boyd working on Banks. Gets it over to Dembo. This is Summers. In the lane, Dembo.
And an excellent non-call. Using the postman again. He's into the flow more the last 10, 12 minutes.
Dembo now has 16 points. And his team has a one-point lead.
He's going to be soft on Wade and help out on the post.
Wade to Gilliam. Kicks it out to Bass Knight for the layup. It won't drop. Here come the Cowboys.
How did he do that?
Question is, what was Lechner doing all the way down this end of the court?
Well, balancing the floor.
Bad pass. The Cowboys get away with it.
After the year with Wade, he's not so sure that the point guard, that's a tough shot. He's missed three out of four.
The foul is going to be on Turk Boyd of Wyoming.
In the game for Wyoming, number
Tark was talking
Billy
about
Jones.
The point guard may be the most important spot after this year, the job Mark Wade's done, not the center, as he thought for so long.
Boyd, second personal.
Mark Wade broke the NCAA single-season assist team record this year. He now has 374 assists. He's inside to Gilliam, and he's fouled.
Boy, Gilliam set that up. Mark Wade, assisted by Wade, turned to the fans from Vegas and said, wake up. But Gilliam sealed and presented himself for the basketball.
Willie Jones.
The overplay is baseline. The kick, very good look. That's just pretty basketball.
Gilliam now has 21 points.
Now, Gary Graham was the key guy on that play. Saw that three-quarter baseline, kicked it to the point.
45-43, UNLV.
Great help there. Gilliam.
Graham, three on one. Left side, Bass Knight. 47-43.
They've got Wyoming playing. Brandenburg signaled for a timeout. The pressure.
Cowboys.
Little zone that time. Two quick turnovers.
Bass Knight gets the timeout. 13 turnovers for Wyoming. 47-43, UNLV. Cowboys come from all over the country. Quite a tribute to the Wyoming basketball program. It's the only four-year institution in the state. And in a time of financial struggle in that state, it has rallied around the positive success of Jim Brandenburg and his Cowboys. You know, Laramie has only 18,000 people, and yet the arena for the basketball team is sold out, and it's a 15,000-seat arena.
Of course, that program's a travel agent's delight.
Gilliam. Make the save, turnover, UNLV.
You don't see Mark Wade make that kind of mistake. Graham looked bad, but it was a tough pass to handle.
Cowboys have gotten careless.
Get a half. Dembo just threw that up for grabs. Bass Knight stepping in.
Running Rebels lead it 47-43.
And Timmy, forget about the communication defensively necessary to play good man-to-man. And Vegas inside, talking through the picks, grabbing guys, making them slide properly.
UNLV is tightening the screws. They are really jumping on it defensively. This is Dembo, throws it away, picked off by Banks, and here come the Running Rebels. Graham.
Let's see Freddie Banks. He's not having a great offensive night. He went down to help his partner on the baseline, came up with that steal.
Great. Personal foul on Gary Graham. I would think, Bill, that the key here is for Wyoming to maintain composure.
Well, this is how they could do it. The big guy down in there in the box, he posts up well. They get the little touch, little tic-tac. But if he uses Lechner and stays within the confines of the offense, he can be devastating.
Dembo inside, has it blocked away. Lechner with the rebound.
He let that one over. Gilliam with the foul. Lechner's close enough to jam it.
That's three personals on Armand Gilliam, the hammer.
Foul. 35. Gilliam, his third.
Chris Tark, you know, he doesn't like his team to talk in the locker room, pregame meals. Al Menendez recruited Albert King, came back, said he liked the music box. He said, well, maybe noise wouldn't be bad.
In 19 years as coach, Tarkanian is 1-1-1, but he's never won at all the NCAA tournament.
Chris Al Menendez, the director of player personnel for the Nets. Old coach, assistant Tark.
Lechner.
Willie, up and over. That's what Lechner should have nailed.
That's the third personal on Willie Jones.
Cowboy foul, charge to number 32, Willie Jones, his third. Also the team's
15
third.
Minutes, 27 seconds remain in this ballgame.
Early in the year in the NIT, they never went to Gilliam in that game. They had a ton of three-pointers, Patio and Banks, but they're looking for him now. So important for this club.
It's a six-point UNLV lead. Oh, nice drop by Jones.
Froze Gilliam a little bit.
I think he was amazed that he came clean down low.
You know, I didn't know how good Gilliam was until I saw him on television because he didn't touch it enough. Bad pass.
Dent. No goaltending. Graham. Boyd, his third.
The alley-oop for Boyd.
Number four on the team.
Banks in motion. You can't go forward, as Hank Nichols explained to us at the meeting, the coordinator of officials. But I just think Banks didn't get there in time before the man leaves the floor. That's the key.
Another change.
Got to be able to come back down.
Well, now the man, if he's moving forward, he's got to be in position before you leave the floor. That's the rule.
49-45, UNLV. We've got 14:34 remaining in the ballgame from the Kingdome in Seattle. The Rebels trying to advance to the championship game of the West. Iowa's already in, and look at the rejection by Dembo.
Oh, Venice. You know, all these officials see big guys play, so they've seen the game played above the rim. You'll see the excellent anticipation by Venice. And a gorgeous rejection.
But they called the foul on Dembo, his second.
The crowd just saw the replay on the big board. Well, that's a shame to be punished for excellent defense.
Watch this.
Of course, the ref always can say the body, but
That is just gorgeous defense.
How can that be the body? He was flying away from the shooter.
Jones dribbled in, ended up with a miss instead of going to Dembo. And he's saying, Willie, I'm the main man. Get it down to me.
Lechner's talking to himself, too. He heard the whistle again and got scared. He's got three personals.
He's only had one tough one against him, though.
Banks from three.
No balance. Good recovery.
Pass by Dembo.
What's amazing, watch Vegas recover now. Everybody back and out. Dembo sees the secondary break and the move. Excellent call.
Banks is called for the foul. There's a technical foul. It's a 51-45 ball game.
So just get one shot for the T and the ball out of bounds.
Technical foul on the
subsequent. Well, now, wait a minute. There's a technical, so he'll shoot that. He'll shoot the foul. We aren't in the bonus yet. You're right.
Non-shooting.
You're right.
Shooting.
Dembo, 3-for-6 from the line. He has 16 points.
Well, he deliberates a long time because they have 10 seconds to release. I just want to shoot a few more. He is finished.
Earlier tonight, Indiana advanced by beating Duke 88-82. And move on and play LSU. Cuts the lead to three. Banks. For three.
Undaunted. He'll keep firing him.
This is Jones.
The defense collapses, you can go side to side.
Nobody underneath for the Cowboys.
Bradley looking to get his feet set for the jumper.
He's trying to get it down to Gilliam. Instead, they go out the Banks. Here's Gilliam inside. Jump hook won't go. Follow won't fly.
Willard
finally the foul on Willard.
That should be it.
And that's it. Five personals on Willard. He'll say goodnight.
They are just teeing it up and going after one another.
33 Hudson.
Good aggressive basketball.
Dirk Boyd.
Of course, the end of it, this little reach over giving Willard number five, but Patio with that slam, and they were going after one another. Anguish. Out in the fields, they probably chew a little of that, would you say, Wyoming?
Willard sits down with 4 points. Minutes, 30 seconds remaining in the ball game. The winner advances to the championship game against Iowa. Dembo.
Logics. Good job.
Dembo
got
Dembo
hurt.
Is hurt. And the he'll stop it. He's holding his knee.
I think what he had on the shot, maybe not one of those banging with the other knee, little bone. There's not a lot of sympathy by the Vegas people. He's had a few things to say. He's tired of hearing about UCLA in Vegas, he said. Wyoming wants a little ink.
It's been said that Dembo's the kind of guy that could give you four shots a side, then beat you on the 18th hole with a double press. Dale Brown, tournament tough, contested, beats DePaul and advances.
Mr. Motivation.
Dent. Lodgins better be careful.
Gives Lechner a blow.
Nice pass by Dent.
Oh, what penetration with the bounce and then finding somebody.
Turk Boyd converts it. It's 54-50.
They are tough. And they've had reason to crack a few times.
They're sagging now, backing up into the paint.
Lodges, what a push. That defense sagging, but what you can do with the dribble, everybody's got to come over. Lodges opens up nicely. You mentioned Boyd with the field goal. Terrific look.
Team foul. That's the second personal on Lodges. It is the sixth team foul for Wyoming. Lechner comes back into the ballgame. Lodges will sit down.
Great double screen.
Gilliam.
Nobody switched from Wade. Set play for Gilliam.
Gilliam now has 25 points. UNLV leads by six. Hudson is all over Dembo.
He's got to get the electric. That frees him.
Dembo still gets free and scores.
Good pass. Jones didn't make the mistake he made earlier, did he? Give it to Fennis when he wants it.
That's 19 points for Fennis.
Not a good one.
The outlet pass. Jones, reverse layup.
Vegas has made more mistakes not balancing the floor than I've ever seen them do.
The lead is two.
Immediately you'll think guards, but of course when you turn over and take bad shots like that, they may be making a cut through.
Hudson follows his own shot.
33, Eldridge Hudson scored it.
58-54, UNLV. Just over 10 minutes remaining. The slam. They come down the other side and there's a foul.
Now he came out of the game. You see him bent over here, a little bit tired. Lacks some stamina. He knows he missed the chippy and it might cost his club.
I think it's more dejection than it is fatigue. 60-54. Time's running out.
We're not a company.
But outstanding people come to us every day.
People who want to make a contribution to a team and do work that really counts.
People eager to see new places, do the unusual, and find the unusual.
People who become your friends for life. People just like you.
We're not a company.
We're your country.
We're the Navy.
The Air Force.
The Marines.
The Army.
We're the Armed Forces.
It's a great place to start.
I like the way you make me laugh. I like the funny things you do. You got a style that's all your own. I like the Sprite in you. You make me want to smile. You know you make me sparkle too. You're such a kick I have around. I like the Sprite in you.
Sprite, the only one with Lyman. The unexpected twist that makes us different, livelier, special.
I like the Sprite in you.
Mazda wanted me to tell you about their brand new 4x4, but I'd rather show you. I hammered
at this truck for days to see for myself just how good it really is. Bottom line, best 4x4 I've ever driven, period. Another real surprise was that Mazda's loaded up SE5 4x4 is priced close to the other guy's stripped down 4x4s. Now, if you ask me, that's worth jumping about.
Like Eric Lechner, so he came to Wyoming here. He should have just drop-stepped and gone up the swipe by Eldridge Hudson. You can see Gilliam sneaking out, and all of a sudden, a quick turnaround. A miss one way, could be a five-point swing. Gilliam with the finish at the other.
Lechner's first mistake was putting the ball on the floor.
Mm-hmm.
Sharks are hungry.
We got everybody now.
One shot. They got a few of them in this building.
Gilliam has 28 points tonight. Six remaining in the ball game.
Continuing the pressure on the basketball. You better have a string when you dribble against Vegas. Make sure it comes back up. Lechner's got his guy. Lechner works hard trying to pin his man.
Lechner. Rebound Dembo. And it'll be Wyoming ball.
Boy, they are wrestling for the basketball. Both clubs, very physical. See that upper body strength by Dembo.
Lechner's frustrated right now.
Pretty good control by Dembo. Nothing there. Dembo's got his guy. He just can't sit. They pressure the ball. When you pick it up, you can't make the entry pass.
Boy, they are all over Dembo. When he touches it, they collapse on him.
Eldridge Hudson came over there. Of course, Gilliam, you're right, helped out.
Charged
to foul to Hudson.
Hudson is first.
That's Hudson's first foul. They keep revolving people down low. Hudson now on Gilliam, and he is riding him hard. In the ball game.
Punishing them on the glass. You have 10 seconds to shoot the basketball.
They're counting. He's at 6.
Officials slow it down as they get to 10. That's sort of a cheap one when you blow that.
61-55, 8 minutes, 55 seconds remain. UNLV now using more time each trip up the court. This is Graham.
Look at
rebound.
Lovely back.
Dent.
The guards aren't turning around and looking. Graham takes the shot. Banks is down in the corner. They can't get balance. The Turk Boyd has done a great job playing Freddie Banks.
61-57. Graham, the foul is on Lechner, and he's hurt.
Lechner went over to try and swipe the basketball.
Wyoming foul charge.
That is Lechner's fourth personal.
Watch the sneak. This is the schoolyard. I used to call a guy for cheating, right? Sneaking along, hanging for the chippy. They've done it often. It's helped them stay close.
Wyoming.
Lodgins comes back in, and Lechner will sit down, hoping to come back in with, say, 3 minutes left. Unless it gets out of hand.
Brandenburg played him, as you know, with those three in the first half, most of the latter stages. So he may go a little earlier than that.
How soon would you bring him back?
I'd wait till about 5, I would say. 3 in the first 5 minutes he had. He played intelligent.
without getting number four. First, you'd watch and see how the game shapes up or takes form before you make a decision.
62-57. But Graham shows you the depth of this club. Bringing the guy, he would start for most teams.
So they get the ball down the floor quickly. Lodges mishandle it.
Dembo, Summer. Drives to Lodges, and there's a wall.
John picked the ball up. Jonathan Summers kept rolling a little bit. He's had a quiet game on the offensive end.
Jim Brandenburg has to be very careful here with 7:56 remaining not to let it get away.
Summers did such a great job against Reggie Miller in that UCLA ball game.
Shut out Miller the last 10 minutes and 58 seconds of the game.
Be a good time to go to Gilliam with Lodges.
Take the Bass Knight with a little revolving door. Moves down low at a 65-57.
Slithering through a great step. So much for your strategy. Lechner's up.
That's right. He's coming back in with 7:25.
You football players with your special teams and your nickel defenses, it's confusing. Keep it simple.
K-I-S-S. Kiss. Keep it simple, stupid. Lechner has 12 points in the night. He has four personal fouls, and there's still 7:22 remaining in the game.
For Rebels, 33, Eldridge Hudson.
Tark has rotated people because they work so hard defensively. The force baseline there by Gilliam, and the help is amazing. And, of course, they drill it every day. That's why they're good at it.
Try to get it inside to Lechner. He can't handle it. It's another turnover.
And Hudson got his hand. Basketball. You put your hands up, you spoil the vision. You can't make that dump underneath.
65-57. UNLV. Three-point shot. Gilliam inside. I'm fouled.
I'm crazy. Why? Things are going so great inside. Why do you need the three-pointer? Of course, negating my theory, good offensive rebounding. They just pound the glass.
You want an answer?
Yes.
Because it's UNLV.
He likes the long one. He figures he can pound the glass. But he's really made an effort. Talking about kids graduating, he's trying to get all six to graduate. Feels he'll be on time.
Armand Gilliam is majoring in communications while you mentioned that. He said he wants your job when he's done.
Well, Tark's taken a lot of heat about the graduation rate over the years, and he feels he's given them a lot, even if they didn't get a degree. But I think a lot of the bad publicity, he's worked diligently to get things squared away, make sure these kids get out with something other than a lot of wins.
He takes that heat because in the first 13 years he was there, 54 of his players of the 67 left without degrees. Now 5 of 6 this year will graduate.
They got the foul down there on Graham. And, of course, to finish the thought, the president wants less academic risk. Therefore, they can supervise the players in a better fashion. But every once in a while, like with Lloyd Daniels and some of the other people, he likes to win, so he'll go out and recruit some kids.
Wyoming has only one timeout remaining. 6:50 left in the game.
Point being, if you take a risk, you've got to really work hard with it.
Three-point shot, air ball. Wade.
Wyoming scores.
68-59 with 6:30 remaining.
He's smiling on the side. He can't believe the easy baskets they're giving up. You asked before about Lechner staying back on defense. When you see a break by your team, you should stay back. Look around.
Wade. And Dennis hurt again.
Hope it's a cramp. Wade's reacting. A lot of times when you see this, it's a banging of two different knees. Inside pass going to help out. Little guys don't belong in there anyhow. See him get kicked, and of course Wade Nails it when it's returned.
UNLV has taken an 11-point lead with 6:12 remaining in the ballgame, and the Cowboys turn it over again.
Hudson. Credit Patio with great defense to deny the long arms. Wyoming trying to get right on top of it.
And Jim Brandenburg takes his last timeout with 6:02 remaining, and UNLV leading 72-59. UNLV. Tark Sharks smell blood. They're coming in for the kill. With 6:02 remaining.
Now the man is overlooked though defensively. Once again, revving it up. You saw Patio earlier cause the turnover. Freddie Banks mentally so tough defensively.
Bad night for Wyoming, turning the ball over.
Got to get it to the Rain players. Get them in the game. Lechner and Dennis Fembo.
Jones, Dembo.
Now Fennis is really coming out deep. If he can get inside, use Lechner again.
3 points.
Yes. Just like I said, get it inside.
On gets assist.
That's 25 for Dembo. It's 72-62 with 5:25 remaining.
They have a lot of heart, don't they? Wyoming, you can't count them out. They're driven by Venice Dembo. Using a little clock.
Patio.
Pick and roll for three.
Rebound, Lechner.
How often do you see that?
It's Venice time.
On a pass. Nice play.
Foul's going to be on Gilliam.
Dembo looked at Lechner. Why didn't you shoot the ball? You heard the whistle.
The UNLV foul charge.
Keep in mind now, Wyoming has no timeouts remaining.
Seven on the team.
They're in the bonus. UNLV has only 16 fouls. And the arrow belongs to Wyoming.
That was just their seventh, Tim. Lechner's able to go.
Eric Lechner is the shooter. One and one.
Both teams now in the bonus.
Pretty intelligent approach to hang in there in that first half and play with the three. Come back in. He's a prospect.
Lechner cuts the lead to 8. The Cowboys are riding right back into it.
Now they got to do it on this end. Suck it up. Get down the stance. They've got a rebound. Offensive rebounding has helped Vegas. Advantage. He's pinned behind. He's got a three-quarter. He hasn't fronted all game either.
Gilliam now has 34 points. He's the only running rebel in double figures.
Almost 5. Look at that trap.
Dead comes back in frustration. Fouls Wade. Wade will go to the line shooting 1-1.
Sean Dent got down.
10, 10, 4 personal foul.
Try and find your way out of this one. At first he had Lechner. Didn't see him. Of course, Boyd's so close there, you can't make the pass. I mean, it's an impossible situation. Tremendous approach, isn't it, defensively?
They just turned the screws.
Mark Wade, the shooter. One
it's great
one.
To have that. Tournament time, you know you can shut the other guy out in an important sequence.
We're under 4 minutes. The lead is still 10.
Now they're denying it. The wings out the point. point. He's made a lot of guys sell sneakers, Tark.
Look at Denbo. He's just posted at the foul line, not moving at all. Now he gets the ball, shoots and scores.
Denbo started.
Shoot it out there. That's a better job. He three-quartered Lechner.
3:15 left. Gilliam. No timeouts left for Wyoming.
Of course, a great high school player, Eldridge Hudson, had a terrible problem with his knee and then operated on half the player that he once was.
76-66.
Still pretty good, though, isn't he? Hudson, he's given him some great minutes tonight.
He really fills a role. Just a two-point shot.
24.
Turk Boyd.
From Denbo.
The lead is 8. Wyoming needs the ball.
Oh, they fell asleep defensively there. 2-on-1, though. You know, his leg went out from under Sean Dent.
Dent's still limping. And Wyoming's still trailing by 10. Banks. It may be insurmountable.
Oh, they give you that uncontested layup. You have to take it, but they'll use as much clock. And, of course, they'll just keep the pressure on, make it as tough to shoot and score quickly as they can.
Lechner inside. And again, he misses a layup but follows his own shot.
43, Lechner.
The lead is back to 10. We've got 1:37 remaining, but Wyoming has no timeouts.
I'm not so sure Eric Lechner has seen this many quick defensive players coming at him on each shot.
The foul on Denbo. That is his fourth personal.
Wyoming is Reggie.
And Iowa, waiting in the wings. Having beaten Oklahoma earlier tonight in overtime.
Jarvis Bassnight re-enters for UNLV.
And UNLV showing now how the West is won.
They just wear on you, don't they?
They're relentless.
Best I ever saw a North Carolina four-corner team played. When Phil Ford was there in the 77 series, you're taking a look there. I believe that's Turk Boyd, isn't it?
Looks like he took a pretty good lick in the eyebrow.
Was when Vegas played them in the Final Four, and Reggie Theus played Phil Ford. They'd stayed at home, guarded their man, and let the man with the ball, Theus, play Ford. I mean, they've been able to do this for a long time.
Coach Dr. Tom Davis.
A lot to smile about, huh? Now he's got it out. Didn't use it much tonight.
Tark is the winningest active coach in the country. 82% of his games. And Graham boosts the lead to 12 points. UNLV just does not leave any room for error because they keep coming at you. If you crack just a little, they're all over you.
Two teams now, Iowa and Vegas, that have the same philosophy. Go after you. 40 minutes. Two heavyweights.
Back for the Cowboys comes 24.
Turk Boyd comes back into the ball game.
UNLV
Banks asked for a timeout. And why would Banks want a timeout here? 82-70 with 1 minute and 12 seconds remaining in the ball game. The Running Rebels seemingly in control. Is called on Dent. They'll go 1-1.
He doesn't believe it. Good rotation there. Jim Brandenburg, full court pressure, and then a trap out of it. That is the limit for Sean.
Now Saturday, as the road to the Final Four continues on CBS, in the East, it'll be the University of North Carolina against Syracuse. That's the second game of the doubleheader. We will start out in the Southeast region. The championship game, Providence against Georgetown.
Eric Graham shoots 1-1.
Providence has been some kind of impressive.
Great story, Rick Pitino. Chris, talking to Gary Graham the other day, he feels he and Mark Waite set the tone for this club with their work ethic. They said they practice hard every day, they go after it, and they hope it's contagious. It certainly was. And sad sight, but a great run by the Cowboys.
Keep in mind, it is a fairly young Wyoming team.
Dennis will be heard from, no question. And UB Brown the other day really was high on Lechner in a UCLA game in terms of a future career.
Dennis Dembo. Dembo is a junior. Lechner is a junior. Reggie Fox is a sophomore. Sean Dent is a junior. And Jonathan Summers is a junior. So the entire starting five for Wyoming returns.
Fox, second personal.
That's the story.
Sure is.
And seven of those eight Wyoming rebounds belong to Fennis, or I'm sorry, Fennis Dembo had several of those.
21.
But of course, Armin Gilliam was the mainstay.
Gilliam had 13 rebounds and 34 points.
There's seven offensive rebounds. Very low profile player, Armin Gilliam. Just plays the game. They get him the basketball, he's happy. If they take the long three-pointers, as Banks will do on occasion, he'll just go to the glass.
Under a minute. The running Rebels, 86, Wyoming, 72.
Willie Jones for 3 points.
The pressure shaking him up.
To Lechner. Lechner on the right side.
Lechner.
37 seconds remain. 86-75.
There's no timeouts. They can't stop the clock. They got a freebie.
This is Wade. To Gilliam.
Fitting climax for a terrific game by Gilliam. Look at Wade back. Can he play the game?
Showtime.
Uh-huh. Light up the strip.
The century mark.
With a cramp
specials time
around the end. That's just from hustling. He's fine. Move the toes. That's what your mother always taught you. Get the circulation going.
UNLV averages 93 points a game. They have scored 90.
UNLV is Gerald Patio.
Now, the man doesn't get the credit he deserves for coaching this game. He's up there with the blue chippers, huh?
56 years old, rarely changes expressions during a game. He has been both exalted and assaulted nationwide, but he can coach.
Oh, sure can. Of course, part of that is the syndrome, maybe anti-Las Vegas, the town, that might prevail. People forget how good or how well he does on that basketball court. Look at those names up there. LIU, Claire B, of course, Adolph Rupp. And Johnny Whitney.
Gary Grant is fouled before the shot. 6 seconds remain. So it'll be UNLV against Iowa for the title in the West. Indiana, LSU in the Midwest. Georgetown will play Providence. Billy Donovan and Delray Brooks in the Southeast. And in the East, it's the Tar Heels of North Carolina against the Orangemen of Syracuse. We're down to eight.
Officials did a pretty good job, too, in a highly competitive game. A lot of banging, a lot of things going on above the rim. The chalk prevails, huh? A lot of number ones still alive.
This will be the last shot of the ball game. For three, it counts, and the game is over. UNLV advances in the West. The Cowboys will go home. So the stage is set for the final act in the West. It'll be UNLV and Iowa. We'll be back right after this. great turnaround jump shot.
Garrett got him on his back that time. Nikita just is so quick coming up off the floor.
Garrett playing with two personals, Callaway with two.
Change of defense now. It's a box and one on offer. Four guys playing a zone, one playing man-to-man.
And Garrett coming back traveled as he came off with the offensive rebound. He was going to muscle back in the slam as LSU takes the lead in the opening seconds of the second half.
Now, in that box and one, and I think what the LSU kids are talking to the official about, all Alford does is keep running off those screens, and if you're playing him, boy, you really get banged. Try to get a little backdoor play there with Wilson and Wilson.
Anthony Wilson.
This club believes.
He hits a two-pointer.
Dale Brown was asking that official over there to make sure it's not three.
It was close. I know I held on it.
Box and one. Watch Woodside chasing off.
Ball on the ground. Diving towards Thomas. Here's Smart. Knocked away beautifully by Wilson. And it goes out of bounds. That was Oliver Brown. Excuse me. I said it was Nikita Wilson. That was number 31, Oliver Brown, who came out of the quickness. And there is the switch signal defensively to go to the freak, which is a combination man and zone. Sometimes it will change depending on where the ball is. The man you would expect to continue to man is Steve Alford out on top. Very hard to play a straight zone defense of any kind against him. And Woodside follows him in the man. Down the baseline comes Smart, knocked away. LSU with quick hands in the passing lane.
Oh, they've been getting that ball. That's three smacks from the back. Downtown, too far out for Steve Alford.
And the open man, Anthony Wilson, bad pass out of bounds.
Took
they had
side.
A layup, and the pass was out in front of him, and it went out of bounds.
You know what was nice move there? Dale Brown is smiling, giving him encouragement, and his team's smiling. They get their head down about that. Nice piece of coaching by Dale Brown.
LSU builds a three-point lead in the early moments of the second half against the top seed in the Midwest. Smart missing. LSU gave Indiana only one shot.
Both coaches didn't think this game would be played in the 70s.
The three, not there, off Smart and Thomas, and out of bounds.
Well, Woodside really went up on the boards that time for 6-5.
Indiana starts cold this half.
Yeah.
Joe's three. Here they come again. Are they unbelievable or what?
And they stay in the box and one. 3-point. Callaway's a man can get open on this offense right here.
Thomas gets inside and gets the roll.
He's the all.
Side and he misses, and Callaway comes down for the loser.
That's a good job. Good job by Garrett.
Callaway off a fake.
Brent, he's the guy that's got to come to the front right now. With the box and one, Alford not able to get those screens down inside that he got with the triangle and two in the first half.
Comes again with that great turnaround, but he's missed his last two, and as Callaway came out, foul is called against Indiana.
I thought that was a pretty good block out by Callaway on that play. Good faking by Woodside.
Someone who agrees with you.
You watch this play right here. Now Garrett's giving Nikita Wilson some trouble on the shot. Touch foul, the way these guys have been banging inside.
And that's number three on Callaway.
Two key players now with three apiece. Woodside for defensive purposes and Callaway for offense.
Woodside inside. Underhand stays with it. And here comes Brown.
showing the good foot quickness right now. Bobby Knight hot. He's hot at Darryl Thomas for not getting his feet over there in position.
The result, he will soon substitute Steve Isle. Indiana down by four.
Good defense.
Forces the turnover. Outlet to Joe. Callaway cannot afford the foul, and Nikita Wilson follows. And LSU can feel it on the bench.
I think Bobby Knight's waiting for a TV timeout, but he's got to get his club back in it mentally right now. It's a big basket here for Indiana. Garrett wanting the lob.
By Joe. He fouled smart as Steve Isle, the 6'6 junior out of Hamilton, Ohio, checks in.
Good pass by Joe because Callaway could have come in there, and there's our man. Huh? You know, he tried to get a personal invite from Gorbachev to go to Russia to talk to Sabonis. He said he spent $6,000 chasing the Soviet star.
Hey, listen, if he wins this, I'd turn our entire peace negotiating over to him. He's a miracle worker. Unbelievable. Yeah. He got help.
You know what scared him off this summer? The terrorists. He was going to go look for Noah's Ark.
No terrorists going to stop him. Bobby Knight can't stop him. It's unbelievable. 57-51. Hard inside. LSU giving Indiana only one shot now per trip down here.
That's a good point, Brent. They haven't been able to get on the boards. Matter of fact, they're making them shoot even that first one as a tough shot. Keaton in good position.
Passes up the shot. He missed his last two on that turnaround. Now he goes to work.
Great block.
Gets it back.
Oh, Callaway's down. His knee is hurt.
And it is badly hurt, apparently. Woodside cleans it up, and we've got an injury timeout on the floor.
Now, Brent, let me point out what a referee's responsibility there. If the player has a chance to get hurt even further, a referee has the right to stop the game, even though the other team has possession of the ball. But since Callaway was away from the action, the official didn't stop the clock, and there comes his mom. Now, Callaway, of course, has had a knee injury this year.
Mother looking on, very concerned. It was injured initially in a practice session, and you can certainly understand the concern. We'll take a timeout. We'll be right back.
The winds of change are blowing at today's Chevrolet. Chevrolet sedan ever built.
The heartbeat of America.
Corsica.
That's day Chevrolet.
You're not just another face along the way to another place.
I'm hoping for a wide body. I probably won't get one.
This flight, you sure will.
You're the pride of United's friendly skies.
I reserved 11G in advance. You probably don't have it.
Got it right here.
So before you go, my friend, we want you to know, my friend, you're not just flying, you're flying the friendly skies.
I like lime in my tomato juice. I probably can't get it.
Oh. When you fly United, you can set your sights a little higher.
Magazine?
You probably don't have anything I'd like to read.
Well, here's an article called Positive Thinking Always Wins.
I know. I wrote it.
You're not just flying, you're flying the friendly skies.
You probably won't believe this. I had a very nice flight.
You're flying the friendly skies.
From the fast-breaking attacks to the ball control finesse, CBS Sports presents the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship next Sunday.
Rick Callaway highlighted. Watch the right knee. He has contact here with Oliver Brown, and it'll collapse. This is the injured knee, and is what has forced Callaway out of the game right there. Down he goes in pain. The play is completed on the inside with a Woodside field goal, and as Billy Packer pointed out, he is out of the play, and they will take him back to the Indiana locker room, but a good sign to see him up and walking. His mother, Eleanor, has returned to her seat here in the Riverfront Coliseum, looking on with about seven members of the Callaway family this afternoon.
That brings Darryl Thomas back into the game. Isle stays.
deflected. LSU getting a hand on every pass internally here in the second half.
Trent, with these quick athletes, you can't afford to throw that kind of a look pass. Look at the rebounds, particularly in the fact that Indiana's getting one and done every time they shoot the ball.
Brown. Hoosiers with a chance. They trail it. It's LSU 59, Indiana 51.
Hoffer just can't free himself from Woodside. There he goes.
Great screen outside and couldn't get the shot to fall, and one and out again. Indiana 2 of 7 from three-point range. They've missed their last five. They hit their first two here this afternoon.
But I think we're all going to have to redefine the word upset.
Peter Wilson.
At this stage in the NCAA tournament, I don't see any bad teams playing. You know, I mean, this club right here is an excellent basketball.